So this concludes this season series. Two wins for Florida, a loss, and two ties as this one ends up 1-1. An impressive game in a lot of ways for Pupa, for Tampa Bay, the comeback, and for Florida, the comeback on the ice to get it done.
You're right about that. A lot of positives there for the Tampa Bay Lightning. Without guys like John Cullen and Bradley, they fought back. They played a pretty solid game. But Darren Pupa really is a great story, considering what he's gone through and the kind of performance he put up tonight.
So they end up tied 1-1 in this one. Lots of other National Hockey League action and big games concerning the playoffs. Bill Pito's got it all for you.
Thanks, Gary and Darren. Coming up on NHL Tonight, the Flyers welcome back Eric Lindros. The Whalers return home for the first time since announcing they're leaving for a new home. And the Canucks try to make up ground in the playoff race. It's all tonight on NHL Tonight. Bill Pito on NHL Tonight. It's great to have you with us. Eric Lindros takes the ice for the Flyers for the first time since bruising his calf last Saturday. The Flyers did go 2-0 without Lindros, prompting goalie Ron Hextall to say, the last couple of games we've played more like a team than we have before. The Flyers now trying to play as a team with Lindros on the road at Washington. And there's Lindros focused. Just 26 seconds into the game, however, Rick Tocchet kicks it out to Adam Oates. Sylvain Côté's got a goal. 1-0 in favor of Washington. John LeClair banged into the board. Power play winding down. Flyers got the pressure on. Michael Renberg bangs it in. Bill Ranford not happy about that. We're tied at one. Watch it again. Lots of bodies in front of the net. And Renberg puts it in. Philly now on the power play. The shot deflects off Lindros. Credit him with a goal. 2-1 Flyers. Lindros got his stick up. His 28th goal of the season. Caps trying to clear the puck now. Dinas Zubrus gets his stick on it. Ranford says, what in the world's going on? Another deflection, 3-1 Philadelphia. Second period, Renberg and Zubrus, and then John LeClair, his 49th goal of the year. That leads the NHL. It's 4-1. Ranford says, enough is enough. He comes out and comes over the goalie. Phil Housley now to Steve Konowalczyk. Rick Tocchet puts it away, so it's 4-2 at this point. Caps another opportunity. Nikolishin in front, but Ron Hextall makes the save. Third period. Bottom of the screen, Dale Hunter and Chris Simon collide. They're on the same team, of course. Simon in obvious pain. Watch it again. The right shoulder, Chris Simon obviously injured as he ran into his own teammate. Simon came out and did not return. Caps down 4-2 here in the third. Trying to get closer. Sergei Gonchar makes it 4-3. Then watch Rod Brindamore coming over, frustrated. Bangs his stick and hits his teammate, Michael Renberg, right in the hand. Brindamore didn't even apologize. Renberg was okay, so too were the Flyers. Lindros adds an empty netter, and the Flyers win it 5-3. So Lindros had two goals in his return. Zubrus, one goal, one assist. Dykhouse had two assists after the whistle. Philadelphia now, 22 road wins, number one in the NHL. The Flyers are 29-2-3 when leading after two periods. Crosby, the leading scorer in the AHL, two assists, now has 8 points in his 11 games since being called up from the minors. For the Caps, Tocchet has 6 points in his last four games. Next stop, Pens and the Kings. Jagr had missed 16 of the last 17 with a bad groin, but he played. First period, Francis shoots. Bergeron in the net makes the save. Francis, though, a big goal. 1-0 Pittsburgh, career goal number 400 for Ron Francis. Late in the first, Mario Lemieux working on Aki Berg in the corner. Something you often do not see. Lemieux in a breakout. Lemieux getting fired up. Lemieux, a do-si-do, and away he goes. Lemieux really going after Berg there. Second period, Nedved drop pass for Ed Olczyk. His first goal since he's become a Penguin, 2-0 Pittsburgh. Middle of the second now. King starts to break out. Jagr with a steal. Goes to Lemieux, to Francis, and it's 3-0 Pittsburgh. Later in the second, it's Francis to Olsson, and he beats Bergeron. As Pittsburgh wins it by the score of 4-1. Jagr back for the first time since February 27th, reunited with Lemieux and Francis. This, of course, is the line that led Pittsburgh to a scorching run during the middle of the season, and the trio was hot in this one. Two goals and an assist from Francis, the 50th player in NHL history to score 400 goals. Lemieux had two assists. Reggett stopping 27 shots for his first win since March the 8th after the whistle. Lemieux now has 875 career assists, passing Phil Esposito and moving into 11th place all-time in assists. Lemieux in his career, 54 career points in 24 games against the Kings. Francis, as you see, playing awfully well in his last two games. For L.A., on Tampa last year, J.C. Bergeron makes his first NHL appearance in over a year, but he got the loss. Senators and the Canadiens, first period, no score. Ron Cutnut, the save on Mark Recchi, not once, but twice. Then it's Andrea Sackle, almost sandwiched by Thornton and Stevenson. Tom Scorsese now. The pass doesn't connect, and back come the Canadiens. This is Vladimir Malakhov. And it's Stefan Richie, 1-0 Montreal. Captains of both teams exchanging pleasantries. Dan Bruce, nasty cross-check on Randy Cunningworth. No penalty. Senators on the power play. Cunningworth, cross-ice to Zoltok. Through the crease, behind Theodore. Second period, Quintal knee-on-knee hit on Radek Bonk. Bonk was okay, though. Then it's Redden to Steve Duchesne. One time, and a bang, and Theodore says, man, I should have had that. Tied at one. 19 seconds after that, McEachern to Yashin, slapper, and a goal. 2-1 Ottawa. Then Jason Tulliver, bad turnover. Tom Skorsky to Daniel Alfredson, but Theodore able to make the save right there. Stefan Quintal's shot, Cutnut to save. Quintal's shot, Cutnut a save. Quintal's shot, Cutnut yet another save. But he was unable to stop Sean McEachern right here. Oh, Ottawa goes up by the score of 3-1. 2:22 after that, Yashin to McEachern. 4-1 in favor of Oh, Ottawa. Thibault comes in. Theodore goes out. It's a final. As Alfredson makes it 5-2. And that's your final score as the Senators win it. Senators finished 3-0-2 against Montreal this season. Yashin, one goal and one assist. McEachern had two goals. Alfredson, one goal and one assist. Big game for Ottawa in terms of playoffs. We'll detail that later in the show. Coming up on NHL tonight, the Whalers return home. We find out how they will receive at home against the Rangers and more after this.
It's about Denver until we get them.
We need to talk.
Talk?
The schedule is getting to me.
I don't hear a word from the other guys.
Well, the other guys aren't running up and down the court with Pippen, Ewing, and Olajuwon. They're not banging on the boards with Oakley and Weber and Malone. They're not out there busting their hump every minute of every game.
Feldman, you're a shipping clerk.
Steal!
NBA Shootout 97. Don't let it mess with your head.
When scorching heat brings on a big thirst, it's called Rocky Mountain Fever. To cool down a Rocky Mountain Fever, you need a frost-brewed beer. A beer that's brewed near freezing to capture the pure, cold truth about Rocky Mountain refreshment. The one beer that's frost-brewed is called Coors Light.
When Quaker State sponsor Jeff Gordon finished first at the Daytona 500, maybe it was luck. And maybe when Quaker State teammate Terry Labonte came in second, it was just another good day at the track. But with Quaker State's Ricky Craven coming in third, you just have to wonder, is there something special in this team's blood or in their engines? Quaker State, the quality the Hendrix Racing Team demands, the quality your car deserves. Quaker State, a clean sweep at Daytona.
Famous fajitas. Our legendary marinade. Grilled fiery and tender. Something special happens with every order. They're guaranteed to capture your attention and your appetite.
Back, everybody. Whalers captain Kevin Dineen says the Whalers found out the team actually was going to leave Hartford 2 weeks ago. The Whalers then went on a six-game losing streak. Dineen says the Whalers' state of flux didn't affect the team on the ice, but the Whalers looked like a different team Thursday night in a win against Tampa the day after the Whalers announced they were leaving town. And Saturday, the Whalers' first home game since making the announcement, a sellout crowd to watch the Rangers, and sellout crowd that turned out. Some of the signs not exactly positive, but overall, not so bad. Early in the first period, Stu Grinson and Ryan Vandenbush set the fight. It's broken up, but then they go Vandenbush is a rookie. He may wish he were back in the minors after this. Stu Brinson. Oh, my goodness. Look at the left. And he just killed the youngster. Still in the first round, Whalers on the power play. Samuelson without a stick in front. Chase and shoot. Derek King, his first goal as a Whaler. It's 1-0. Hartford, watch it again. Keegan and Drew is stick to Samuelson, as you'll see. Samuelson misses it, moves out to get it. That leaves King wide open in front. And that's how they score the goal. Closing seconds now of the first. Jeff Sanderson carries in, muscles around Driver. Sanderson's 33rd goal of the season. That leads the team 2-0 well after one. Wayne Gretzky had a number of chances in this one. First period, Gretzky coming down on a 2-on-1. Nicks the post. And then, in front, shot it too high. Second period, Sundstrom. A tip-in attempt, but Cork says, Middle of the second now. Samuelson, the lead pass, taking in with a break. But watch, Goodenia come down, number five. Beautiful play to break it up. Whalers up 2-0 after two. In the third, Jeff Spookaboom gets it from Graves. His second goal of the year. Rangers just down 1-2-1. They have a chance. The Rangers pull Healy for the extra skater. Graves gets it in front. Cannot get his stick on it. And the Whalers win at a score of 2-1. Perhaps the key to the game, the Rangers have the second-best power play in the NHL, but they went 0-for-5 in this one. Marc Messier not playing for the Rangers. He's got a stiff knee. Sean Burke, 25 saves. Jeff Sanderson was worried the team would get booed. That's not what happened. Said Sanderson, it was nice to hear the cheers, and nothing's changed on the ice when we go out and play. The Rangers have scored 240 goals this season, fourth most in the league. But Glenn Healy wouldn't know it. The Rangers score one goal per game more with Richter in net. Healy this season now just 5-11-4, but he's played much better than that. Leafs and the Lance, first period. Brent Severin, the shot, gets his own rebound. Potvin is able to cover it up. DJ Smith and Rene Corbeil, right of your screen. And away they go. Corbeil doesn't have a helmet. And now Smith doesn't have a helmet. And they're both helmetless. Down they go. Lance on the power play. Hendrickson with the short-handed shot. Looks good, but Ozolin kicked it out. Dips it after one. Craig Billington now. Nice cover-up. Still no score. Then it's John Clem. Richter. Kaminsky gets the rebound. 1-0 Colorado. Kaminsky scores the hat trick the other night against Montreal. Well, I should say Detroit. Still in the second. Clem. Nice pass to Corbeil. Pass. Hotman. Six side. 2-0 Colorado. A minute later. Steve Sullivan deflects to Clark. Clark then gets the rebound. Beats Billington. Watt out with a bad shoulder, suffering the fight the other night. 2-1 Colorado. In the third now, Jason Smith the shot. Bears in on the rebound, and that ties the game up at two. Late in the third, Mike Johnson shorthanded. Toronto goes up 3-2, and looky, 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 Toronto beats Colorado for the second time this season. The Leafs had been 0-26-2 when trailing after two periods, but they come back in this one. Toronto now 4-1-2 in the last seven road games. Potvin 34 saves. Avalanche not only without Wah, Louis Krupp and Keith Jones also did not play. Elsewhere, Canucks and the Flames. First period, Trevor Linden picks up the puck. The Martin Jelena takes a shot. Brian Noonan then gets it in front. And it's 2-0 Vancouver. Later on, Yves Racine to Theo Fleury in back. Racine's stick breaks. Canucks say, we'll take it. Noonan to Linden. And it's a shorthanded goal. 3-0 Vancouver. At that point, Trevor Kidd came out. And Wayne Rollison came in. Second period, 3-1 Canucks. McGillney just out of the box. Breaks up the play. Look at the tremendous speed. Vancouver goes up 4-1, and they win it by the final score of 5-2. A huge win for the Canucks, who are now just 3 points behind the Flames in Chicago in that tight race for the last playoff spot in the West. Jelena, a goal and an assist. He gets to 30 goals for the second straight season. A goal and an assist as well from McGillney and Noonan. The Canucks now unbeaten in their last four. After the whistle, Vancouver winning back-to-back games for the first time in 2 months. Linden had 2 points. Calgary has given up a league-high 18 shorthand goals. And Iginla, 2 assists. He leads all rookies with 50 points. Coming up on NHL tonight, why the Hobey Baker Award may not be a good award to win. Paul Freer, though, is an exception.
What's a good price for a new washer?
Oh, geez, about $400. Oh, I just bought one for $350.
Oh, around $250.
At some stores, a good price for a new washer would be under $250. A great price would be below $225. But at Sun, the everyday low price for this Roper large capacity washer is just $197.
That's a great price.
For guaranteed low prices every day on appliances, there's only one place to shop.
Sun.
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 The name to remember is Sun.
I win again, yes! The boys just can't keep up with old Granny when it comes time to eat at DJ's Country Place.
Mmm, I can smell that hot, delicious barnyard butter from here. Those two farm fresh eggs, biscuits, and country fries, all covered in my homemade sausage gravy, and just $2.99. You boys are sad letting an old lady beat you. Hot! Wait on in the DJ's Country Place. We'll cook up something special just for you.
NBA Tonight. Tonight at midnight, only on ESPN2.
I'm Reese Davis. Later on the NBA Tonight, the Nets look to extend their winning streak over the Bulls to 2. A look at the Knicks floor leader who does it from the sideline, and a trip to the House of the Rising Sun. Join Fred Carter and me, midnight Eastern.
They just dropped the puck in Phoenix, Edmonton in town. Phoenix leading the Oilers by 1 point for fourth place right now in the West. Edmonton 2-0-0 against Phoenix this year, outscoring them in the two games 10-4. College hockey, the championship game. BU North Dakota, first period. Chris Drury, perhaps BU's best player. BU goes up 2-0. Second period, North Dakota down 2-1. Chris Kelleher trying to clear the puck, gets stripped. David Hoogsteen ties it up at 2. Then it gets physical. Brent Dufoy, the huge hit on Peter Donatelli. Still second period, tied at 3. Matt Henderson will get the goal. North Dakota goes up 4-3. Under a minute left in the third, BU down 5-3 on the power play. Off the deflection, Mike Sylvia takes a shot. John Coleman there to poke it through. BU down 5-4. 37 seconds left in regulation. 15 seconds left, they pull the goalie, Adam Calder. Empty net goal to ice it for North Dakota. They are the national champions. The final score over BU was 6-4. Hoogsteen and Matt Henderson each scored 2 goals in the second period. 5 goals for North Dakota in that second period to overcome the 2-0 deficit. They win their first national title since 1987. BU was trying to win its second national title in 3 years, but they come up short this time around. On Friday, Michigan's Brendan Morrison won the Hobey Baker Award as the best college hockey player in the land. Morrison led the nation in regular season scoring with 26 goals and 52 assists. Morrison was a second-round draft pick of New Jersey, but decided to return to Michigan for his senior season. Now that he's won the Hobey Baker Award, Morrison may wish that he hadn't come back to win the award, because Hobey Baker winners have not done well in the NHL.
The Hobey Baker Memorial Award, college hockey's equivalent to the Heisman Trophy, but the Hobey Baker is an unknown award in an unrecognized collegiate sport.
I don't think too many people are aware of exactly what the Hobey Baker Award is.
Given to the top college player in the country, the Hobey Baker should be a precursor to NHL success. But of the 16 non-goaltenders who have won the award, only 2 have scored more than 100 goals, and just 4 have even scored 100 NHL points.
I don't know if it's a jinx, that goes along with it.
Only 3 of the award's 17 winners have found true success in the NHL, and just 1 of those 3 has been in the league more than 3 years.
Rockman into forecheck, heels it. Rockman on goal, scores! Neil Rockman for Minnesota!
There have been some players that maybe stumbled after winning the award.
It's kind of been a jinx.
It's never, you know, how good you are at that level. It's how good you're going to become, you know, and some guys can play really well at that level, and just can't make the jump to the NHL.
Only Neil Broughton, the award's first winner, has seen his name also engraved on Lord Stanley's Cup. And then there's 24-year-old Brian Holzinger, the 1995 winner who has arrived.
Leaving it to Holzinger, the shot scores! Brian Holzinger, and a zinger zips it home!
Holzinger has played in all but one of Buffalo's games and is among the top five on the team in scoring. And there's a 93 winner, Paul Kariya, who is quickly placing himself among the game's elite. Having faced the pressure of being the Hobey winner, Kariya is now getting consideration for the 1997 Hart Trophy.
If anything, I felt less pressure. Not a lot of the past winners have gone on to have great careers.
If you receive this award, that means you got a guaranteed spot on an NHL team. No, I don't look at it that way. Everyone's got to earn their spot.
And that's exactly what most Hobey winners have tried desperately to do. Hart Trophies and All-Star appearances have very rarely followed Hobey Baker's success.
It is a different league. You're playing against bigger and better players, stronger players, and there's a lot of adjustments that you have to get used to.
It doesn't matter what you do until you get here, you know. I mean, you can have all the awards and accolades and be everyone's top prospect, but if you don't come here and perform and improve, you're not going to have success.
Holzinger and Kariya could be the start of a new trend, or they could just be two recent winners that joined Broughton in escaping the jinx. Only four Hobey Baker winners have over 100 games and 100 points in the NHL. You see the list. 1996 winner Brian Bonin is in the minors in the Pittsburgh organization, and only two others have never played in the NHL. 1989 winner Lane McDonald and 1986 winner Scott Fusco. So most Hobey Baker winners get a chance in the NHL, but few have become standouts. Coming up on NHL Tonight, look out! Here come the Islanders. Another contender in the playoff race. And now, tonight's question, more on the Hobey Baker Award. Can you name the only goaltender to win the Hobey Baker Award? There it is. We'll have the answer for you right after this.
Can MasterCard help stop a thief? Any credit card can make you feel secure when you have it. But how many can protect you as well as MasterCard when they're lost or stolen? The answer lies the tamper-resistant panel that MasterCard pioneered. It makes a stolen credit card practically useless, and your MasterCard even more secure.
First goal, Bob, just like in Detroit when they throw an octopus on the ice. Up here in Canada, it's so Canadiens.
Gonna be a while. Grab a Snickers.
If you smoke pot one time, it probably won't kill you. But if you keep smoking it, you'll kill your brain cells, and you might just get dumber and dumber and dumber and dumber and dumber. Well.
You always dreamed of making the majors. Now you have a second chance with ESPN's Ultimate Baseball 7th Inning Sweepstakes, sponsored by Hager and Holiday Inn. Just correctly predict the score at the end of the 7th inning of any April 1st ESPN game and have a chance to win a trip for two to a 1998 Baseball Dream Week. Enter at your local participating Hager retailer or Holiday Inn hotel and watch the games on ESPN. Enter ESPN's Ultimate Baseball 7th Inning Sweepstakes and get into the game.
Tonight's question, can you name the only goaltender to win the Hobey Baker Award? And the answer is Rob Sauber, the 1988 winner playing at the University of Minnesota. Sauber has been a king, a saver, and now he's a minor leaguer in the Washington organization. Bruins in the aisle, first period, first shot on Jim Carrey. What else? A goal. Brian Smolinski. Isles up 1-0. Islanders' second shot of the game. What else? Jim Carrey is lost. Brent Hughes with a goal. Carey was pulled into the second on an Islander power play. Ziggy Palfy makes it 5-1 Isles. And then Palfy scores again. Final seconds of the second period. Palfy had a hat trick. The Isles crushed Boston 8-2. The Isles right in the middle of the playoff race now. Palfy, the hat trick and an assist. Molinsky had two goals and an assist. And Robert Reichel continuing his great play since being acquired from Calgary. Reichel with four assists. Lightning and the Panthers. Darren Pooper. Finally back in the lineup for Tampa. Just his third game of the year. He was great on that sequence, on this sequence,
Darren Pupa was great all game long. Lightning shorthanded. Mikhail Anderson weaves in. Shot hits the net. Rob Zomner on the rebound. It's 1-0 Tampa. Second period, Anderson's shot hits the post. And it's cleared from the crease. Puck behind Beezer. And oh, so close. Lightning just four shots on goal in the game at this point, late in the second period. Terry Kartner picks it up. On this sequence, after Beezer made the save, Kartner picks it up, bangs it in there. Caught at one, was it redirected? Watch it again. Yes, Tom Fitzgerald. Late in the game, ties it at one. In OT, Zumner alone in front, loses control of the puck. Kirk Muller dumps it in. Kloss knocks it down, but Fitzgerald gets the shot off, and Pupa makes the save. And the game ends in a 1-1 tie. Pupa, 28 saves, his first appearance since February 14th, and just his third appearance of the season. Panthers NHL high, 18th tie game this season, and 25th overtime game this season. 18th OT game that ends in a tie, and 25th OT game overall. John Cullen did not play for the Lightning, out with the flu. More now on the game from the guys who called it, Gary Thorne and Darren Fang.
Here in Miami, Florida did not get that tying goal until 18:35 of the third period, and the man who get it is our guest here, Tom Fitzgerald. Tommy, just another tough game, but I guess you guys get used to playing these sorts of games.
Absolutely. Every time we play Tampa Bay, it's a rough game. We know it's going to be a low-scoring game. Darren Pupa played really well tonight, as well as John Van Biesburg. We put a lot of shots on net. We were bound to score, and lucky enough we did with a couple minutes left in the game.
I couldn't have waited any longer. Let's put you through the game-tying goal here. Put it through.
Well, the puck came out. Their guy didn't clear it, and Terry made a great play knocking it down. He just really picked the guy. Terry took a step to the middle, and I just got my stick on it. And good luck there, and goes in the net.
Was it important to get some traffic in front of Pupa, because they seem to block a lot of shots, and at first you couldn't get them actually through?
They really do. Their forwards collapse excellent. Just to get the puck to the net like Terry did, as you see, Hamilton there, or whoever the D was, just stepped up, and I kind of just went around him. He kind of forgot about me.
Tom, a team ready for the playoffs, the Panthers?
Absolutely. I think our first goal was to make the playoffs. Now that we're in, it's something that we have to focus on and keep fighting for home ice advantage, because it's such a big thing in the playoffs to have the home ice, especially with our fans down here. We feel they're the best fans in the league, and it's the loudest building. It's a great place to play.
Tom Fitzgerald, congratulations on the game-tying goal in this one.
Thank you very much, guys.
Tom Fitzgerald, our guest, 1-1 tie here in Miami.
All right, guys, thanks. Now look at the East, 1-6. Philadelphia, Buffalo, New Jersey now 4 points behind the Flyers, Panthers, Rangers, and Pittsburgh. And then look at the bottom half of this conference now, after play now, as a result of Saturday's activity. Montreal, the Caps are technically in eighth, but look at what's going on underneath the Caps. Whalers, Isles, Senators, Lightning, all very much alive.
It's Smart Time on the 97 Mazda Miata. Lease for $199. Add rockin' sound on the lease blast, too. Have your hair blow-dried on the lease flies, too. Hug the road and the sky on the lease sails, too. Have the summer of your life, and you get the idea. Now, get the passion of the Mazda Miata.
In yet another torture test, we drained the oil from this car and added just this much Castrol Syntec. We then ran it over 100 miles per hour and waited. You see, Syntec has a unique molecular structure that bonds to engine parts. And if a little Syntec can protect under these conditions, imagine what a full oil change can do. Castrol Syntec protects in ways other oils can't. And now, try Castrol Syntec Power System, a new kind of fuel system treatment.
Subscribe today to NHL Center Ice. You'll see hundreds of games. Only $89. Available through DirecTV. NHL Center Ice. From your friends at the NHL and ESPN.
Find it in your heart, sir. Ma'am, it'll help you. Thank you. I am a former NHL netminder. Oh, right there. Thank you, sir. Still got it. I had my goals against average ruined by Jeremy Roenick in the effortless way he moved the puck through traffic. Hey, I'm working this corner, pal. I want back in the NHL. Thank you. Oh, you see that, sir? I got in front of that. I want another shot at Jeremy Roenick and the shiny Nike skate. Ow, that's a safe thing. Right there with the gloved hand. Hey, I don't come to your office and stare at you, sir.
Thank you.
You want change with that nickel?
3 Stars of the Night is brought to you by Nike, who encourages you to participate in the lives of America's youth.
Stars number 3, Sean McEachern of Ottawa, 2 goals. Senators beat Montreal by the score of 5-2. Our number 2 star, Ron Francis of Pittsburgh, 2 goals, including career goal number 400, as the Pens beat L.A. Final count in that one was 4-1. And our number 1 star, the line of Ziggy Palfy, Robert Rifle, and Brian Smolinski of the Isles, 11 points as the Isles beat the Bruins 8-2. Our game Saturday night, Tampa and Florida, a 1-1 tie. Ed Jovanovski of Florida benched a healthy scratch. Darren Pupa in the net for the Lightning for just the third time all year. Plays very well, giving up only 1 goal. More now in the game for the guys who called it here, Gary Thorne and Darren Fang.
Bill, it was a strange game. The two netminders certainly played extremely well. The 2 goals that were scored did not come easy.
No, they really didn't. It took a lot of hard work. Darren Pupa was solid in goal. He really actually surprised me with his calmness in goal for the Tampa Bay Lightning, considering that he just hasn't played in what seems like an eternity for Darren Pupa. He was calm. The Tampa Bay Lightning kind of hung around and hung around. They couldn't get any offense going, but as a team, they really solidified their place anyway by gaining a tie. In first period, this is a big play because they didn't have any scoring chance. This was a shorty. Great play by Anderson going wide, and there's Dammer just following up with a loose change. It's the 16th time that the Florida Panthers have given up a shorthanded goal again.
They had 2 shots on goal in the first period, and that was the one that got by. John Van Beesbrouck watched most of the game at the other end while it was going on, while Darren Pupa was doing the work. But Florida's used to tough games and coming back.
They really are. They do. They hang around. They peck away, and eventually they get a scoring chance. They're not rattled or unfazed by the fact that the game's 1-0 with only a couple minutes left. A wonderful redirection by Tom Fitzgerald on a good hard shot by Karkman, because you got to give Tampa Bay credit. They did block a lot of shots in this game.
So Tampa Bay's still in line for a playoff spot. 1-1 here in Miami, Bill.
All right, guys, you can watch the Panthers again here on ESPN2 Monday night against Pittsburgh at 7:30 p.m. Eastern Time. And we'll be on with the NHL tonight, Monday night, right after that Panthers-Penguins game, sometime after 10 p.m. Eastern Time. The NHL, meanwhile, on Sunday, L.A. will be at New Jersey. Anaheim will be at Detroit. Buffalo at Chicago, critical game. The Blackhawks right now in 9th place in the West. Elsewhere on Sunday, we have Dallas at Vancouver. The Canucks with a big win over Calgary Saturday, back in the thick of things in the Western Conference. And Philadelphia, back in action, will be at the St. Louis Blues. So that'll do it. Everybody seems to be alive for the playoffs in the NHL. I'm Bill Pito. Thanks for watching. Coming up next on ESPN2 is qualifying for the Brazilian Grand Prix. We'll see you back here on Monday.